Hello and welcome to this video on how to use Gpower to calculate the sample size you need for a multiple linear regression. This video is going to cover two types of Gpower analysis. It's going to cover calculating the sample size you need for analysis. So that typically would be done at the point where you're designing your study. You've got your questionnaires in place and you're wondering how many participants do I need? And then we've got post hoc, which is where you've run your study, you've collected all your participants, and you've not achieved a significant result. And then you want to know how many more participants you would have needed to achieve that significant result. So just to briefly explain to you what the relationship between the sample size is and effect size. So basically, if you increase the effect size, the sample size you need to achieve a significant result goes down. Equally, if you've got lots of people, then the effect size you need to have will go down as well. Okay, so a couple of key terms. So effect size is a measure of magnitude of the effect independent of sample size. So for example, if you think about Cohen's D, Cohen's D is just used in kind of t-tests and things like that. And the idea is that it's the difference between the means. So you'll have a mean for group one and a mean for group two. And the bigger the difference, the bigger the Cohen's D, and it just controls for standard deviation. You've also got things like sample size, which is just the number of people in your sample. And then power is the probability that the test will find an effect, assuming that one exists. And Cohen, in 1992, recommended that you choose a power of 0.8, recommends that you choose a power of 0.8, an 80% chance of not making a type 2 error. So in other words, an 80% chance of finding a difference if one exists when conducting a priori power calculation. So with that being said, let's go and actually run a power calculation. So to do this, I recommend you use a piece of free software called Gpower. So if I just go and pick up a random tab, type in Gpower, and it will take you to this website here. And you can download it for Windows, you can download it for Mac, and it gives you reference there. So if you want it for Windows, this is where you would download it. If you want it for Mac, this is where you download it. It's a free program and quite useful. And the link will be in the discussion section. So once you've done that, let's go and load up Gpower. And because we're doing a multiple regression, we want to go F-test because it's part of the F-test family. We want to go linear multiple regression, deviation from zero. And then what we want to do is, because Cohen tells us that you want a power of 0.8, we'll enter in 0.8. And because our number of predictors, let's say that we want five predictors. So let's say we've got a model with five IVs or five predictors. And then what we want to do is calculate what our Cohen's F is. So our Cohen's F is the effect size that Gpower uses. And the easiest way to do this is to use the determine feature. And then what you want to do is go and find your R squared value and then enter it there, and then that will transfer it to the main window. So if we pick a sample paper at random. So let's go for this paper that I just found online, which was open access and kind of seemed vaguely interesting. So it was on predicting occupational stress from emotional intelligence and coping styles. What you can see is if you come down here, you will see that they've reported the R squared value. So what we want to do is take that R squared value, like so, and enter the R squared value into here. So 0.818. Click calculate and transfer to main window, and that will then give us our Cohen's F there. You can see that it tells us that for Cohen's F, 0.02 is small, 0.15 is medium, and 0.35 is large. Then you just click calculate, and you can see that we would need 64 participants. So the advantage of taking the time and using kind of previous literature to determine what you want your effect size to be is that you can get a more accurate one. So let's say that we didn't have an accurate one here and we just went for a medium one. So we went for a medium one, which is 0.15. Click calculate, and you can see that we would need 92 participants. 92 participants is often obviously a lot more than 64 participants. Therefore, you're putting yourself to a lot more energy and effort, collecting a load of participants that you don't need, potentially wasting your participants' time as well as yours. Equally, if you were just to use a rule of thumb, so let's say you were to use 15 predictors for each IV, which is the classic Stevens recommendation, and you had 5 predictors, that would mean that you would have 75 people. So once again, you'd be collecting more people than you needed. So if you're wondering how to report this, I would say the following. And a priori Gpower, so it's a priori because it's before conducting your statistical test and designing your analysis. Gpower analysis was conducted, reference for Gpower, and based on a Cohen's F of 0.022, which you will find there, taken from Arnold 2019, which is the sample paper I found, and a power of 0.8 in line with Cohen's 1992 guidelines, it was determined that for a multiple linear regression with 5 predictors, you would need a total sample size of 65. And then you would give your references. And you can see that the 65, 64, much of a muchness really. But that's how you would report and carry out an a priori Gpower calculation. So now let's pick another scenario. And the another scenario is you've collected your participants and you've not achieved a significant ANOVA. So if I just show you here, here I've just got some random data and I've performed an ANOVA, and you can see that the ANOVA is not significant. Okay. And you can see that we had 2 predictors, age and sex. So given that, and given that we achieved an R squared of 0.107, we want to go and run a Gpower calculation to see how many more participants we would have needed. So if you come here and you change it to post hoc, and then what you want to do is you want to calculate your R squared. So in our specific example, our R squared was 0.107. So once again, you would go and enter it into that. Let me just check I've entered that correctly, which I have. Calculate and transfer to main window. You can see that that ends us, or gives us, a small effect size because it's less than the medium effect size of 0.15. It's only just a small effect size, but nevertheless. And you can see in this specific example, we only had 23 participants. So what we'll do there is we'd enter in 23. We had 2 predictors, which were age and sex. So we'd enter that in there and then click calculate. And you can see that we achieve a power of 0.26, which is lousy basically. You really want to be achieving a power of 0.95. So what we would then do is we'd then go and take this idea, move into a priori. It saves our effect size, it saves the our alpha value and the number of predictors. We want to change that to 0.95, which would give us a significant alpha value. And then you would see that you would need a total sample size of 132. So if you're wondering how to report this, you would say the following. So reporting a post hoc Gpower calculation. As the model was not significant, a post hoc Gpower calculation was conducted, reference to Gpower, and an effect size of 0.12. And I've put in brackets small effect size, Cohen 1992. In order to achieve significance, you would need a sample size of 132 to achieve a significance at 0.05 level, so an extra 109 participants would be needed, and you'd put that at, in your results. So the a priori you would put in your, say, your method section at the end of your method section. The post hoc you would only carry out if you didn't achieve a significant ANOVA, and that would be in your results section. So hopefully that's been useful, but if you've got any questions, please do feel free to email me on c.hickton@newman.ac.uk.